What's non-negotiable is that Christ is the one who redeems us and saves us. There's no one else. He is the way, the truth, and the life. The next issue is, how much do you need to know about God?
Yeah, and this is a scary thing, because you evangelicals out there, if you go out evangelizing and you give a clear presentation of the gospel to a person who's never heard of it before, and if they reject it, from the non-Calvinist point of view, you've sent them to hell. You did. Because there was a chance that they might go to heaven because they would be judged on what they knew, which was nothing about Jesus. Then you give a clear presentation of the gospel, and all of a sudden now they could be judged according to what they know, which is the true gospel, which now they have now rejected. Now they're going to hell. I tell you, you evangelical missionaries, you got to be very careful to play it safe. Why are there any missionaries at all? You'd be better off doing no evangelism. Now, I know God commanded it, but you got to say, hey, God, I know you want me to go preach the gospel, but if I do and they reject it, I mean, I'm kind of responsible for imparting this knowledge of the truth, and then they reject it. Just say, forgive me, Lord, but I'm going to disobey you in this one area so this other person doesn't suffer an eternal torment. You know, the thing is, Christians are listening to me right now, and they're like, they're disagreeing with me, but yet they see the logic involved, and they're going, he's kind of right. And it makes me feel bad.